have your attention, please. We still have folks coming in. We ask you please squeeze together a little bit more. Let your teammates in the stands with you. Once again, please squeeze together a little bit so we can get everybody in the building for tonight's matchup.
like it. So here you go.
Good evening, everyone. VHL has asked me to ask you for everyone to squeeze together and make more room. There's more people coming in and needing seats. So please keep the aisles clear, keep the exits clear. The ushers will be going around keeping the aisles and exits clear. So if you would assist in this, we would appreciate it. If you could help everyone get a seat that you can, it would be greatly appreciated. Thank you.
and we welcome you to Radford, Virginia for the 2018 VHSL Class 2 Boys Basketball Quarterfinal featuring the Gate City Blue Devils at 25-2 and the Radford Bobcats at 27-0. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the NFHS Network and the championships right here online at nfhsnetwork.com and also live on Facebook here. Andy Hayes alongside Neil Connor, and we got a great one here tonight. The sensational Mac McClung and the Gate City Blue Devils, Neil, come into town trying to knock off the defending state champs and 27-0 Bobcats here. We couldn't ask for a better matchup, could we?
No, sir. It's going to be an exciting atmosphere in here tonight, Andy. Getting in here was absolutely a challenge, and I expect this is going to be one for the books, definitely.
Well, at the end of the day, you know, we can talk all we want about Mac McClung, but it's a team game.
It is.
And they've got to play well as a unit here this evening to beat Radford. Head coach Rick Cormany, one of the best in the state of Virginia, has won several state championships with different teams. And he's got a great group here tonight, and they're undefeated. I mean, look, all the hype's been about Mac McClung, but this is a tremendous Radford team.
Absolutely. No losses on that side of the ledger. And, you know, like I told you, I watched a lot of those kids growing up playing AAU basketball and tournaments I used to run, and they absolutely have had a team attitude from the get-go, and they used to run people out of the gym, and it shows, you know, that building experience is definitely paying off.
Radford getting set to make their entrance. You can hear the crowd tonight. This is a raucous environment. We've got basically standing room only all the way around, and people are trying to fill in here, even on the steps. That's how packed this place is, and it's a college atmosphere right here for a big high school state playoff game.
I know the Highlanders would love to have this type of crowd for a game. You know, this is something special tonight, and I doubt that either of these teams will disappoint us, Andy.
Well, let's go ahead and run through some starters here for head coach Scott Vermillion and the Gate City Blue Devils. Mac McClung, we'll talk about him quite a bit here tonight. Bradley Dean, David George, Drew Vermillion, and Zach Irvin, a great five here for Coach Vermillion. And they have been dynamic. They played a lot of great competition. What do you like about this Gate City team?
Obviously, you know, they have a leader, and he has overshadowed a lot of the guys on the floor throughout the year as far as press coverage and that type of thing. But they got to have more than one piece. As you alluded to, it's a team game, and they do have some other good pieces. And obviously, they have proved their mettle, you know, coming off a tough one last week. But definitely ready to go.
Go ahead and get to the starters here for Radford. Quentin Morton Robertson, the point guard, he's dynamic. He can do it all here tonight. P.J. Prelo, Cam Cormany, Cam Edwards, and Miles Jones. Miles Jones round out the starting five here for Coach Cormany. And this is a unit that has state championship experience. That matters, doesn't it?
It sure does. Even though they don't have a single senior on the roster, you know, they're definitely challenged and tested. And again, these kids have been playing. I know Morton Robertson's been playing with kids that are much older than him. I watched him play up three grades and still be the best player on the floor when he was younger. So nobody's got a bit of scared in them, I don't think, at this point, Andy.
No, and these guys are ready for this moment. You take a look at Mac McClung. He's the all-time leading scorer in VHSL history. He surpassed Allen Iverson. We'll have more with that at halftime. That's a pretty incredible accomplishment.
Yeah, it is. He passed Allen Iverson, that's right, with 984 points. And let's, I guess, catch the...
Let's do the national anthem here. We'll honor our country. And we'll come right back here and finish our pregame. They're almost set for a showdown of epic proportions. Cade City and Radford for the right to go to the state semifinals here next week. And with that, I'll throw it back to my color commentator here tonight, Neil Connor. Neil, you've watched a lot of these guys.
I have.
And you've seen them growing up and what they've done. These are well-rounded basketball players, aren't they?
They really are. And they do understand that team concept you're talking about. And a lot of them are pretty good-sized kids, too, which certainly doesn't hurt in basketball. Have not seen as many of the Gate City kids except, you know, the highlights of McClung. But they're obviously a power in their own right. And really excited to be here tonight and watch this thing in person. It's going to be something special.
Starters being introduced. Mac McClung. He's a human highlight reel. He's been all over SportsCenter. You know, you have to assume tonight that Coach Cormany has said, look, we're going to let somebody else beat us if they're going to beat us. It's
right.
Not going to be Mac McClung.
Right. And that was Graham's, you know, their formula in that game when they won last weekend. And they basically said, we're going to take him away and everybody else has to beat us. And the coach, I think, applied some pressure a little bit farther up the floor than most people had. Didn't let them settle into their sets. And we'll see if Coach Cormany follows suit.
For Gate City, they got to find a way to get him in the flow, because once he gets going, he's one of those guys that just starts rattling off baskets, three-pointers, dunks. I mean, he's an energizer bunny for his guys. And the fact of the matter is, the more he does it early on, the better for Gate City, right?
Exactly, yeah. They don't want to let him get out of control early. And as you mentioned, does have the VHSL single-season scoring record and took that from a fairly prominent name in Allen Iverson. And he's still chasing about 80 points shy of the total point record held by Caleb Tanner of Floyd High School, another young man I got the pleasure of watching a lot as he was coming up. So pretty important for him to keep this going and see if he can leave his mark on both records.
Well, we're excited for this one. It should be a great ball game. Hope you're enjoying watching it back home, wherever you might be.
Yep, it's going to be something special. Andy Gates is out there ready to roll. Just waiting on the Bobcats to get out there and get this thing started.
There he is. Mac McClung trying to keep his season going here with his teammates. Tough chore tonight. Undefeated Radford.
Yeah, and I saw some of the Radford kids warming up out there in the hallway before the game. And like I say, they've got good size and certainly look plenty confident. Going to let somebody else take care of the jumping duties here. I guess McClung's a little better at the running than jumping.
It'll be Miles Jones jumping here for Radford. And it looks like David George will do it for Gate City. And we're underway. Ball controlled by McClung and the Blue Devils. First possession, the toss underneath to George. He'll go up strong, left hand, no good. McClung tries to keep it alive, and it goes out of bounds back to Radford.
A little bit of hesitation under the basket there, Andy. I thought if he'd gone straight up, he probably would have been all right. I think he thought the defensive pressure was going to come a little hotter, but it didn't.
Morton Robertson across the timeline, being guarded tightly by John Compton.
Radford content to settle in here a little bit.
Prelo underneath to Jones, and Jones will throw it away.
Got to get the jitters out in one like this, all these folks in the gym.
Much like we talked about with McClung, Radford with Miles Jones down low, you could be sure that Gate City has a plan for him. Quickly up to David George, now back out to Compton, and they'll set the offense up. Double team for McClung. And he's going to be forced out of bounds. And they're going to call a foul here. Looks like it's going to be a foul on the Bobcats.
I thought that was a pretty good call. You know, they're going to have to keep him pretty clean. And he definitely rode him out there on the sidelines.
So a double team right from the start. They'll do it again. McClung trying to get to the edge. Can't. Ball ripped away by Morton Robertson. He's got it. He'll push it. Three-point shot right side, no. And the rebound comes down to Zach Irvin. Irvin now wants to run. Finger roll, no good. Rebound, Blue Devils. Bradley Dean got the first points of the ball game.
Nice move, way to get on the boards.
Quickly back the other way, a shot and a foul attempt. Coming here from the line.
You know, I'm sorry, Andy. I like the fact that the officials are keeping this one pretty tight early on. You know, two good teams can look awfully rough if they let it get out of hand early. So,
free throw good.
Thought both those were pretty good calls.
Second one as well.
Trelo draws first blood for the Bobcats.
3-point shot from Compton. Right side. Got it.
That's a good looking
wide
stroke.
Open.
Yep, good looking stroke, Andy.
Morton Robertson says, let me give it a shot. No good. McClung's got the rebound.
Well, there might have been a little contact on the arm there, but no call.
They're leaving Compton open. Jones comes out. And a turnover. Morton Robinson throws it ahead to himself. And it's going to be taken away off of Bradley Dean, they say. But good hustle by Dean to get back and knock it out of bounds.
Great defense there. Gate City hustling back. Knocked it away cleanly. Stopped the fast break.
Morton Robinson out top. Now the left side to Cormody. He wants a jumper. This one a little bit off the rim. Too strong. Here's Irvin. Up to McClung. McClung around the defense. Throws it up. No good. Ball tipped out. And it hammers our cameraman down on the court there, Christian Sowers. Great crew here for you tonight. Helene Shane is our producer. We got Jacob Spears on the top camera. Austin Sowers on our graphics. And Irvin will tip one in for a bucket. And Dwayne Ashwell also helping us tonight on our floor cam.
Yeah, that one's a little too easy. Got to make sure you know where everybody is and certainly got to protect the lane first.
Entry pass inside. This one to Edwards. Turnaround shot, no good. Here's Irvin. He wants a three-pointer. He's got it.
And this is what Radford can't have happen.
Oh, another three-point shot.
Morton Robinson answering there very quickly, which they needed to do to stop the bleeding.
Gate City up early, 10-5. Here's McClung from the right edge. Good.
Oh, wow.
Right over the top of the defense.
Yeah, that one's disheartening for the defense. Thought they had him pinned up pretty well.
There's Jones, tries to take it right, can't do it. Tipped away, Irvin back quickly. Wants another three. A little bit short. Orton Robertson on the rebound. And he wants to run. Shot attempt, no good. On the floor.
Well, and I think both these teams need to not get too far ahead of themselves and try to go for the throat punch here right out of the gates, Andy. They need the ball, and, you know, as much as a big three will help you, it can kill your momentum if you come down and chuck them up and keep missing them.
Substitutions in. Andrew Sharp, one here for Gate City. Off the bench for the first time here tonight. He's out top. For Radford, John Woods in the ball game. Here's a three again. Morton Robertson heating up from outside.
Showing a little range on that one, Andy. He was way outside.
Here's Irvin. Driving, tries to kick it back. They're going to call an offensive foul. A little bit out of control. Good call right there.
Yeah, I thought it was a good call as well. And, you know, at this pace, we're going to have a pretty high-scoring game if Chris keeps up.
Edwards will toss it in to Morton Robertson. And they'll set the offense out high. Good matchup there. McClung guarding the talented point guard for the Bobcats.
He's definitely minding his defense as well, Andy, even though he's an offensive threat. Trying to keep up with Morton Robertson. Nice pick.
Runner in the lane, no good. After the nice pick from John Woods, he gets the rebound. Woods hands it back in, and they're going to say a traveling call. Good call there. Going back to the Blue Devils.
I thought that was the right call. Should have gone straight up with it. Try to get a little cute, get everybody off the floor. Sometimes you just got to go up and take your lumps if it gets blocked. Radford pressuring the ball here. Graham had some success doing that against Gate City as well.
Full court pressure, a double team on McClung. And they'll toss it in quickly. Here's McClung running the floor. Body shot on the floor.
I think he gave him the bucket, Andy.
Let's see what they say. Looks like he may have twisted his ankle a little bit. Bucket was definitely good after the foul there, but
yeah, I don't think that's the right call. That was definitely on the floor before the shot, but kind of gave him the NBA continuation rule there.
No, they did not.
Oh, they are
shot.
Putting it on the baseline. You're right. That's good. That's the right call.
Here's Irvin from the corner. Three-pointer, no good. Kept alive, and it'll be Blue Devil ball. Bounce pass underneath, and a foot on the line. Sharp did the best he could to keep it in, but he couldn't get the momentum to stop. He stepped out of bounds.
It was a great idea. He knew he was coming there. Good look, but tough to handle that pass. Had a little bit too much bounce on it. Honestly, the ball looks a little bit tight. Not sure they shouldn't throw the needle back in that bad boy for a second.
So Morton Robertson, Miles Jones, working it up the court here. Bounce pass in now. Potential shot passed up there by Prilo and a turnover. Probably should have taken the shot. He had an open one.
Yeah, tough to pull the trigger sometimes in these type of situations.
McClung fighting through the double team, finds a way with the jumper. Great shot right there. Here's a left-handed layup by Prilo. No good. Gate City ball.
It was a good move. Just didn't quite get it in the bucket, but nice little take.
Here's a three from Compton. Good again. And that's a great sign for the Blue Devils. If you're going to double McClung, somebody's going to be open. And so far, Compton has been money from the outside.
He has been. And I think if you don't get a score right here, you almost have to call timeout for Radford, depending on how the next 30, 40 seconds go down. You just don't want to let this thing get out of hand early.
Morton Robertson from three, a little bit short. Tip. And a foul. McClung bopped in the nose on that rebound attempt, and they're going to call a foul on Mack.
Oh, wow. No. I think it's on Radford.
It is on Miles Jones. Never mind. Looked like they were pointing back the other direction.
I know. Yeah, for a second, confusing. I thought you were right. I was going to say, holy cow. And I'm sure his season's been a little longer than most kids. You know, when you get the type of attention he does, you get a little extra razzing, a little extra elbows here and there. Sure, he's got a few bruises.
Irvin, now out top. Compton again, left all alone. He likes that spot on the right wing.
And they've yet to really get out there and get a hand in his face, Andy.
Long three-point attempt, no good. And it comes down to the Bobcats. Miles Jones on the rebound. Here's Morton Robertson, back to Jones. Three-pointer for him. Good rotation, a little bit off, and that one comes back to Bradley Dean. Here come the Gate City Blue Devils. 10-point lead. Dean drives, has it swatted. They're going to call a travel. Good defense by the Bobcats there.
It was great defense, and I think good job by the officials so far. Really have been on point with all their calls. I kind of don't understand the lack of ball control a little bit, really on both ends of the floor. Offense is as good a defense as you'll get. Just hang on to it. Get a good half-court possession every once in a while if you don't have the numbers in transition.
Minute 5 left here in this opening quarter. Andy Hayes and Neil Connor with you. Here's a turnaround shot by Edwards. No good. Quickly ahead to Compton. And now McClung on the baseline underneath. Oh, my goodness.
And that's where he's dangerous, Andy, down there next to the rim. Not much you can do when he gets that type of penetration. Fans wanted to walk there, I think, on Morton Robertson.
There's Morton Robertson to the lane. He's got the bucket. Drops in.
I'll tell you, he slashes in there at will. He is quite the player, just like I remember. Doubling him up.
Trying to get around the double team again. Backdoor lip underneath, no good. Turnaround by Irvin, and he's fouled. And he'll go to the line for two shots.
I'll tell you, McClung's got a great cast of supporting characters here that would probably be all-stars on any other team. And they're not all-stars on this team, but would probably be the man in a lot of other spots. I like it when it gets to this point in the game, Andy. They start to settle in a little bit, calm down a little bit.
Got to get rid of the nerves in a big game, no question about it. That one's good. And at the buzzer.
Oh,
almost good from way back there. After one, 21-10. Gate City with a great start. Keep it right here, and we'll show you some highlights.
That was a good first quarter, Andy, yeah. Gate City obviously outshot Radford, for sure. But, you know, the Bobcats seem undeterred. You're a good ball club. You don't let 10 points get you down. I do think they're going to need to concentrate a little bit more on having better half-court possessions. Couple easy ones showing there.
John Compton with a couple three-point shots. Mac McClung from the edge. Doing a good job here from downtown. Morton Robertson saying, I can do it too.
Yes, sir.
Don't leave me open.
26 feet. Give it to me. Nice take right there by McClung.
This is what is amazing when you come in with a plan to double-team and watch him. I mean, he's just...
Yeah.
He's going to get around it and still go make things happen. That's what the college coaches are going to love about him.
Yeah, he's mobile and slashy and, you know, has put in the work to get to that point, too. I mean, you don't just you're born with some of that ability, but you absolutely have to put in the work to make it that much of a success.
Andy Hayes and Neil Connor with you here on the NFHS Network, live from Radford, Virginia. If you ever wanted to feel like you're in the game, you're with us right now. We are almost in the crowd, basically. And this setup here, it's a great atmosphere. And we hope you can feel that excitement back home.
Yes, sir.
Neil and I have been waiting all day for this.
Yeah, I've been looking forward to this for the week, Andy. This is good stuff. Tough call there away from the ball, but, again, the officials doing a good job of keeping this one in check. I always think good teams benefit from good officiating, calling the game a little tighter.
Andrew Sharp back in the ballgame for Gate City. Here's Jones going to work underneath. No good. Good defense by Sharp.
It was a good defense. That was a great move. Just got to put it in the bucket.
Bradley Dean out top here. They're shadowing McClung. Double team immediately. As soon as he catches the ball, they're not going to let him have an open shot. He's going to have to create. He'll go right. Jones comes over, help defense, Sharp wide open. Compton again from downtown. Oh, another great look, almost, but it comes out.
Well, with the double team, it definitely has the ability to become the Compton show.
Jumper from P.J. Prelo.
I think it was Morton Robertson, I'm not sure.
Great dish to the edge there.
Yeah, it was. And, you know, Gate City's going to have to move the ball around a little bit out of that double team. If you got two on him, somebody's got to be open.
Ball off of his foot there from Irvin, and a foul called on McClung. And that's another way to minimize his impact, is get him in foul trouble early. That time, a little bit of a reckless foul.
Fouls on Mike McClung. his first team fifth.
Yeah, he got a little aggressive there, kind of lost his got a little bit overzealous and couldn't quite stop. Good call by the officials.
There's Cormany out top. Trying to work the pick and roll with Jones. Couldn't do it. Good rotation by the Blue Devils.
Well, this is the type of possession that I do think benefits Radford.
Long three-pointer from Edwards. No good. Bradley Dean's got it. He'll push it here for Gate City. In the corner, Compton again. Now Jones saying, I'm not going to give you an open one, but Mac McClung comes right behind him, and he had a better look. He didn't make it happen, though.
No, and, you know, I don't know. The three-point line, I'm a little conflicted about it in general. Obviously, I'm hearkening back to an age most of these kids don't remember.
Tell us who you think will win today's game right here on the comment section on Facebook. And tell us your final score prediction. We'll see if you're right. It's always fun to be able to interact with you during the ball games here.
Trip to Tahiti, right?
That's right. No matter where you're at. No, no, there's no trip to Tahiti, no. A trip to the state semifinals that's on the line for Monday or Tuesday, depending on where it is and who wins.
Yeah, if Radford wins, my understanding is it'll be back here.
McClung trying to go behind the back as it's stolen away. Quickly ahead to Cormany. Inside to Prelo. And a nice jumper on the backboard. Good. Great ball movement right there. And a well-timed timeout there, probably to stop a little momentum.
Well, Gate City, yeah, they had great defense there. That was just a super take. Nice shot. Almost looked like it got blocked a little bit on the way up.
So the state championships will be in Richmond at the Siegel Center next week, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. But yeah, the state semifinals are actually going to be hosted by the High Seeds for the first time in a long time. I know this because I've always gone and called the state championships, and some years it was 30 games in a row or 36 games in a row, you know, all week long. But they've changed it the last couple of years. Last year was a super sight. You know, this year it's High Seed, so games will be all over the Commonwealth. And, of course, it all depends on who will be the winner here tonight and all across the other games and so forth. That said, should be fun for some home area, you know, crowds to get to. Like, this crowd right here is fantastic. One of the best we've seen.
Absolutely.
And, yeah, it's always great for the kids to play here.
I was
going to
say, win or lose, these kids will remember this forever, man. This is a great experience for them. And for their parents and all the folks who have supported them as well.
So out of the timeout, Gate City basketball with the 21-14 lead. McClung still being double teamed.
Yeah, they're absolutely staying on him like a wet blanket. They are not going to let him beat them.
Irvin in the ball game. John Sally in the ball game. There's a basketball name for you. Here's a shot attempt. Travel call on Irvin. He made the bucket, but it won't count.
Yeah, I thought that was a pretty tough call, honestly. I didn't see it, but obviously the ref's right there on top of it. So
they do have a better view.
A little bit, yeah. Yeah, just a little. Although this crystal clear picture that you're providing here is pretty easy to see as well.
It does look nice. Under five left here in this first half. Here's Cormany with a fall-away three, no good. Momentum was going away from the shot. And it threw it off a little bit. Here's Irvin for three. Got it from the corner.
A lot of kids on this Gate City group that can shoot. Radford slowing it down a little bit here. Content to work it around, even though they're down by 10. Trying to pick their spots, get it back in their playmaker's hands, and he'll jack it.
Morton Robertson, a little shy. Here comes McClung. He wants to push it. Compton calling for it. Good job by Morton Robertson to come out because he's been money. And there's an offensive foul. John Sally called for it underneath the basket.
And that
will give it back to Radford. You know, you think John Sally.
Right.
And we think the Bad Boys. I mean, Detroit Pistons.
Yep.
back in the day. Boy, were they good.
Old ACC guy.
All these kids playing, they don't even know who those guys are.
No.
I'm talking about grandpa and you know, great-grandpa.
I was going to say he's old enough to be grandfather.
We're just dating ourselves a little bit on that conversation. Here's Miles Jones. Strong move, but no good on the bucket. Zach Irvin back out top to Bradley Dean. Now McClung. And he's grabbing the attention of two Bobcats every time. That's the strategy. Yep. Jumper doesn't matter.
And that's what they're going to have to do. They're going to have to pick on the ball if they're going to get McClung free. It's the only option they have.
There's Prelo. Shot contested, knocked out. McClung's foot was on the line when he touched it.
That's great defense. Good move, but just was able to get that cat-like hand in there and knock it out. Unfortunately, he was standing on the baseline.
Cormany trying to find an open look. Bradley Dean guarding him tightly. Here's Jones, turn around, hangs, and he gets the roll.
Got that one that time. Same move he did a minute ago, but wasn't able to put it in the bucket, and that time he took a little longer look, got himself set, and knocked it down. Good move.
Still a 10-point lead for Gate City. Great pass underneath, and a foul called on Cormany. John Sally going strong to the basket.
Well,
and he'll shoot a couple.
When you get to that point, I don't think that's a bad foul at all. You know, make a kid shoot two 15-footers when he's got a chip shot layup.
Substitution in for Radford. Braden Moore. Checking back in.
See what he can do with the second one. Makes it. Good shot.
Braden Moore, Jr.
Raffer going to a little bit more of a half-court set here, which I think is a good call. They have not shot as well as Gate City so far, and it's tough when you come down and put it up. And
here's don't Morgan Robinson.
Oh, what great a move.
Great move right there.
Yep, great move.
And a turnover, another steal in the corner. The double team is working. Here's Cormany for three, no good. Sally's got the board. And Gate City will push it up. Through Vermillion. Back to Irvin, now Dean, left side, he'll drive.
Nice
left
move.
Hand, good move, a little strong off that rim. Jones has got the board.
Man, use that glass. I'll tell you, it is your friend.
Ooh, Morton Robertson to the dish. He's got it.
Made it look awfully easy that time, Andy. Can't let him get that type of penetration straight to the bucket.
McClung double team. Out top, somebody's open.
Gotta be. Gotta cut. Gotta cut to the middle. Somebody's gotta move.
Jumper right side, no good. Jones again. Great position underneath to Cormany. Jump shot, baseline, no good. 42 seconds to go in the first half.
Well, the pace hasn't necessarily dropped off. The scoring maybe has just a little bit here, but good first half of basketball. Both teams giving 100% effort, as you might imagine, in this venue. But playing defense hard and not giving anybody anything easy.
Playing for the last shot. Bradley Dean. Out top. 10 seconds.
Got to go pretty soon.
Dean will go to the left side. Gets it underneath to Sally. The bucket with 2 seconds to play in the half. And that'll wrap up an impressive start to this one. The Gate City Blue Devils. up 29-20 over the Radford Bobcats. We'll step aside for a quick break. We'll come back and show you some first half highlights next here from the Dedman Center in Radford, Virginia. You're watching the NFHS Network.
This isn't Madison Square Garden. These drills probably won't make anyone a number one draft pick. But these players are practicing for something important. While they work on their jump shots, they're also learning teamwork, discipline, self-confidence, how to deal with wins and losses. Skills that will make them winners long after they leave the court. Support high school activities in your community. Because when kids take part, they get set for life.
Now you can create your own tour of Italy from Olive Garden's most mouth-watering dishes, starting at $12.99. Choose 3 of 10 classic favorites to enjoy on one plate, like our delicious new shrimp ravioli with lobster alfredo, a filled pasta like irresistible tortellini al forno, and a classic like creamy fettuccine alfredo, plus unlimited salad and freshly baked breadsticks. Because the best tour of Italy is the one you create, only at Olive Garden. We're all family here. Breadstick lovers, your new favorite lunch is here. Breadstick sandwiches.
Shakespeare said that all the world's a stage, and men and women are merely players. But Mr. Shakespeare never met Stephen Curry. Nihao, the guy who was in the gym every dang day. Patriot Saint, I'm the underdog, the league's most unguardable player.
Bang, he knocks it down.
So my apologies to Mr. Shakespeare, because onto the stage of mere players enters the babyface assassin. And he's about to write his own story.
Fall back.
This isn't Madison Square Garden. These drills probably won't make anyone a number one draft pick. But these players are practicing for something important. While they work on their jump shots, they're also learning teamwork, discipline, self-confidence, how to deal with wins and losses. Skills that will make them winners long after they leave the court. Support high school activities in your community. Because when kids take part, they get set for life.
Now you can create your own tour of Italy from Olive Garden's most mouth-watering dishes, starting at $12.99. Choose 3 of 10 classic favorites to enjoy on one plate, like our delicious new shrimp ravioli with lobster alfredo, a filled pasta like irresistible tortellini al forno, and a classic like creamy fettuccine alfredo, plus unlimited salad and freshly baked breadsticks. Because the best tour of Italy is the one you create, only at Olive Garden. We're all family here. Breadstick lovers, your new favorite lunch is here. Breadstick sandwiches.
Ball is life feature here at the half. Mac McClung as he sets the VHSL record for the most points passing Allen Iverson. Our Ball is Life feature brought to you by ballislife.com. We thank them for their partnership here at the NFHS Network. And Neil, just watching him do his thing. He's not a selfish guy. No. He will pass the ball to the open guy. And really, I mean, he's got every aspect of the game.
He does, Andy. And the thing about it is, you know, if you decide you're going to be a one-man show, you make it awfully easy on the defense. because they know you're not inclined to pass. And, of course, it helps if you got guys that can do something with it once you pass it to him. And it's clear that he does. His teammates are solid basketball players, so you can't cheat on him, that's for sure. He's a special talent. I don't know that we're going to get to see any of those electric dunks here with the defense that Radford's playing on him, but it's been fun to watch both these teams so far. We need to see what he does the next level. Headed to Georgetown. Really be interested to see how he competes.
Going to Georgetown, and at one point this year, one of the opposing coaches said, well, you're going to go and just sit there and not play. And I think he scored 47. that got him going a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't see that at all. I see a superstar. I see a guy that can translate to not only the college game but even beyond because he's got so many skills.
I agree. And, again, the will to work on those skills. I mean, you know, I think he's one of those guys who just won't be denied. You know, you tell me I can't, and I will. And that's the type of thing that really a lot of guys graduate from mediocrity through hard work. Real greats, you know. You hear the stories about Michael Jordan getting cut from his JV team and this and that. And those are the points in life that drive those guys and change them and make them the huge success that they are in the future.
So this game was a little bit earlier this season when he set the record. Allen Iverson, one of the great players of all time, obviously not only in the NBA, but in the state of Virginia from Bethel High School down in the beach area. And a lot of guys would say he's just as good on the gridiron. He was that great of a quarterback as well. Had a storied career. Yep. How ironic is it that he played at Georgetown? That's where Mac McClung's going.
Yep.
And he breaks Allen Iverson's record. Just, you know, a neat story. And the one thing I'll say is that everything that you have seen about him after the games and how he talks about his team and his teammates, he's a very humble young man.
Well,
you know, he hasn't let all this attention really get to him.
No, and so I was talking to somebody today, telling them about the fact that I had the opportunity to do this tonight. They showed me a picture of their son with him at the gym at Salem. He played in a tournament there at Salem High School. And apparently he stood out in the lobby and took pictures with kids for two hours after the game, man. Just a solid guy. Super solid kid.
Congrats to his parents.
His dad's a Hokie. So, yeah, I mean, it can't be, but so bad.
I'm disappointed that Coach Buzz didn't get after him and get him down to Blacksburg. I'm a Hokie myself, as you know. And
yeah, me
you know,
too.
He would look good in maroon and orange, but I know there's a lot of coaches that are probably kicking themselves a little bit for not being a little stronger in their recruiting efforts. And you watch him knock down a three here. So
I think so. And, you know, to go to a place like that with to have Mr. Ewing coaching you up there, obviously a great in his own right. I'm sure he'll be able to produce whatever Matt McClung's got in the tank and get the best out of him.
Again, watching our Ball Is Life halftime feature. Matt McClung's record-setting night.
And not sure how many he's got so far. He had 1,040 coming into the game. He broke Iverson's 984 single-season record. Still chasing, as I said, Caleb Tanner from Floyd for the career record of 2,770 points. And he was about 84 shy, if I'm not mistaken, before this game. So
you could see if you can get a couple more games, it's possible.
Well, averaging 38.5 on the season, you know, three games should put him over the top. But, of course, he's garnering a lot of attention down the stretch here, as we've seen tonight.
Radford has definitely come out with an approach here in this first half to say, hey, look, you're really, really going to have to work hard at grabbing any buckets tonight. And he's been unselfish. He's passed the ball to his teammates. He's worked on helping his guys get open. As that was the game or the record-tying or winning three-point shot right there to go above Allen Iverson. They stopped the game. Just a great moment for Mac.
You can see the humility there. Very emotional. That's a lot of work, man. A lot of work to get to that many points.
Got
to
celebrate these young guys and gals in the state of Virginia when they do great things. Congrats to Mac McClung. Although I will say this, knowing just the type of competitor he is, He doesn't care about their record. He wants to get to the state championship.
Right.
Right now, his team is up 29-20. So we're back here at the Dedman Center. Getting ready to start the third quarter of action. Andy Hayes and Neil Connor with you.
Looks like the Blue Devils are going to have it here coming out of halftime. No, it's really early in the second half, but it'd be great for Radford's cause to get a stop and a bucket right here, get this thing back down to a little bit more manageable difference.
So Gate City with the basketball to start the third quarter. And they've got a 9-point lead. And the alley-oop attempt to Matt McClung falls short. Miles Jones pulls it down. Here's Cormany for three, and he gets fouled. He'll take three free throws.
Yeah, not quite enough oomph on the alley-oop there, and then that's a tough foul on any three-point shot. It was good defense, but got to control your body and not let a shooter have three looks at it from the foul line.
First one good. Cam, the son of Coach Rick Cormany.
I'm not sure what his average is on the year, but I'm sure it's pretty high. I bet he makes more than he misses.
And how exciting it has to be for him to be able to come in and be a contributor, a major contributor on this team, playing for his dad. Probably as a young boy, watched all the great teams at Radford that Coach Cormany's had. And been waiting for that opportunity. Pretty special, I'm sure, for both the coach and the young man knocking that free throw down. He got two of three.
Well, special for his pops as well, I'm sure.
There's McClung on the left corner. And it's going to go out of bounds back to Gate City. That ball knocked out of bounds by Radford.
Good defense on both ends of the floor. Straight hustle everywhere you look.
Oh, there's a steal. Prelo tips it up in the air, and he'll go coast to coast. He misses it. Morton Robertson there for the rebound and puts it back up and in. Good hustle by Quentin Morton Robertson.
He's all over the floor.
Here's Irvin. Right side, no good, a little off. Cormany's got it. Long rebound. He'll push it. Three-pointer, no good. Sally pulls it down. Here's McClung back the other way. Again, trying to beat the double team. And he's going to throw it off of Jones underneath the basket.
Great defense on the baseline right there. I mean, he kicked it eventually, but really McClung had nowhere to go with it. So great job there shutting it off.
Irvin being contested by Edwards. A toss to the corner to Compton for three. That one no good. Sally fighting for the rebound. Here's Irvin.
The fans are thinking Radford might be getting a little bit too much hands on him here.
Foul is finally called.
Quentin's going to be the loser in that whole thing. That sort of built up a little bit of reaching and whatnot there, and finally he was the one that got the whistle.
Here's McClung out top. And Compton back and forth on the weave.
Well, and I think going forward in this tournament, both these teams are going to have a little bit more of this look. Because obviously when you get to this point in the season, teams know what they're doing. You know, I think it's tough when people hang their hat on whether or not you shoot well one night or you don't.
There's a jumper right by the top of the key. Left side, no good. Bradley Dean, a little bit off on that one.
Good look, just didn't put it in. That was a good possession. Likewise, Radford going to slow it down here a little bit.
Back out. Here's Edwards. Wide open three. He's got it.
Huge bucket right there. That's what you got to do. Work it around until you find that soft spot. That one guy gets lost, and then you got to execute. Nice job there by the Bobcats.
Here's McClung underneath. Oh, he's got it. And quickly back the other way. Prelo can't get it to drop. Had a great look.
Well, and he's had a little bit of a tough night trying to get it to go in. Had a couple nice looks. Getting to the basket real well. Just some nights that thing's a little bit smaller than others.
From way downtown, McClung fires one. No good. Rebound, Sally. Back it in. Over the top of Jones.
Nice job being squared up to the basket, being in the right spot, and taking it straight back up. Don't put it on the floor. Don't give them time to recover. Good job.
Here's Morton Robertson. He's got it. And look what's happened here. All of a sudden, Radford just started chipping away. They're chipping away back to 3 points. That's all the lead is for Gate City.
Yeah, not sure who took the time out there. There's Ford Robertson putting it back in on that rebound, and then the big three here, nothing but net. A lot better possessions here in the last few minutes by both these teams. Great job on the stick back. And then, of course, Robertson starting to heat up. Everybody's finding their rhythm, Andy. It's going to be a good one.
4:31 left in the third. 3-point game. Gate City out top, but Bobcats on a run. They started down 29-20 at the half.
Well, Radford was the higher seed, correct?
Yes, they're undefeated.
Yeah, yep. That's what I thought.
Here's McClung in the lane, goes around. Jones gets a bucket to fall in from Sharp on the follow. A little strong.
Thought he might have traveled before he shot that, but really opportunistic play there by his teammate to crash the boards and stick it back in.
Andrew Sharp has had a few nice plays tonight off the bench. Always love those guys that come off and give you some energy.
Yep.
He's done that tonight.
Yeah, some guys just fit that role a little better, it seems. Definitely settling into the half-court situation here a little bit more.
Entry pass to Prelo. He goes into the lane. Oh, that's Morton Robertson. Nice move from the point guard. Looked like a big man down there.
I'll tell you, man, he's tough to guard. That's all there is to it. Just moving around anywhere he wants to on the floor at will. Just a junior. Got another year to go.
McClung. Shot attempt, no good. Sharp saves it, though. Great effort right there. Back inside to Irvin. Got the bucket. Credit Sharp on the effort. And it leads to points.
Well, you know, Andy, you watch this game, and Gate City's up by 7. And really, McClung, from a scoring standpoint, has not been that huge of a factor. So, you know, his team obviously has just as much credit for success here as...
Here's
wow.
Morton Robertson again. Nice move, but no results. 37-30 the score. 2:39 to play, third quarter.
Nifty little spin.
Gate City out top by 7. Trying to get that lead back where they had it. Long pass to Sharp. Wide open. Looks inside to Irvin, and he's fouled from behind by Edwards. He gets called to reach it in.
Been a pretty clean game so far. You know, the officials set the tone early, as I mentioned, and it's been a good basketball game. Not letting them get away with a lot of nonsense. Gate City content to run a few seconds off here.
Irvin inside to Dean. Jumper rolls around the rim and out. Radford basketball. Quickly back to Morton Robertson. Offensive foul call. And a good call right there.
I thought it was the right call as well, Andy. Had plenty of time there to change his course, and the defense had staked their claim. I thought that was exactly the right call.
And I think that is that two or three on Morton Robertson at this point. Got to watch his foul situation. There's Compton. Wide open again for three. No good. Has gone cold. Gets the rebound back from Sharp, who kept it alive.
McClung wants to rock. He's ready to do something. And McClung, there it is.
There it is. Left hand. Pumps his fist and says, let's go.
He wanted a foul, I think, and I'm not sure he's wrong. I thought there was some contact there, but he's so strong, it almost just looks like he was unscathed.
Lead back to 9, 39-30. Gate City out front, Cormody for 3, left wing. Looked good, a little strong though.
Good shot.
Urban, good board. He's going to push it himself. Jumper, 10-footer, no good.
See him.
Quick tap back to McClung. He's got it in.
He gets bailed out by his teammates, but that's the one when you're looking at a one-on-3.
Basket,
yeah, good
no good.
Yeah.
Foul will be called on Gates City. Morton Robertson fouled on the floor.
I mean, when you hit one of those running down one-on-3, it's a great momentum booster, but it's just not really smart basketball. So, you know, it's definitely a risk-reward situation. That time he wasn't rewarded, but if you make it, I guess you look like a hero. McClung going to pick up one here. Been three pretty good quarters of basketball here, Andy. Scores a little farther apart than I'm sure Radford would like for it to be at this point, but.
There's Morton Robertson out top. Picks up his dribble.
A reset. Play for one. I think that's good. A coach down by 11. You don't want to panic. You don't want your kids to panic. You know they can catch up.
Radford will play for the last shot.
Better go pretty soon, though.
Morton Robertson with it. Will work right side. Three-pointer, no good. McClung on the rebound. And Gate City will head to quarter number 4. With an 11-point lead. One quarter away from a trip to the state semifinals.
Yeah. Things starting to get a little bit chippy down there. McClung's starting to get a little frustrated. People smacking on him, pushing on him. And I'm sure that's got to get old.
Show you some highlights from the third quarter. Andrew Sharp. Did some good things in this quarter right here. He saved that rebound. Had the putback. McClung with a nice left-handed move. Then Irvin with the steal, the tap to McClung. This game had pulled closer to 3 points, 33-30. And back out top to 41-30 now. So a great run. 8-0 run to close out the third quarter. Andy Hayes, Neil Connor with you. I hope you're enjoying our coverage live from the Dedman Center in Radford, Virginia, the Class 2 boys basketball quarterfinal.
Well, this is a spot where Radford's going to have to start putting a stitch in this thing a little bit more. Maybe work a little bit quicker. Try to close the gap. Because if it goes the other direction much more with only a quarter to play, it's tough to get back into it with these 8-minute periods.
Radford basketball has started. Quarter number four. They need a run. That tighten up the defense. Their undefeated season in limbo right here. Here's Cormany for three. Got it. Left side. Big shot right there from Cam Cormany.
Yep. Textbook. Great stroke.
There's Dean up to Sally, and he'll lose it. Back to Radford it goes. Great pass by Dean. The big man couldn't hold on to it. Ball Radford, a couple big buckets here, Neil, would be a great momentum booster.
Yep. We're definitely getting that first one help. Ball getting a little greasy there for Gate City, it looked like.
Jones working on the block. Turns. Got a good look. Puts it up and in. Five straight for the Bobcats.
Might switch his pivot foot there, but no call.
And a steal. Prelo yanks it away from McClung. Cormany pump fakes. Throws the three. He's got it. Eight in a row. 41-38 in a timeout from Gate City.
Well, things definitely shaping up as absolute best as they could here to start the fourth quarter for Radford. Now I see why Coach Cormany certainly wasn't too nervous. Got back in this thing in short order. Cormany's got a sweet stroke. If he heats up, that's going to be a problem. Going to have to keep up with him a little bit more for sure.
Again, the momentum goes back and forth in these kind of games.
It does. Yeah, two good teams. You know, and you see that across all sports, obviously. Oh, I thought he walked right there. But, again, no call.
Pump fake. And Cormany tosses it down. Couple big shots. And we got it back to a three-point game.
And now it's time for Gate City to answer. They really need to have a good possession here and get a bucket. Here we go. See what they got. The man leads him up the floor. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Not McClung.
Irvin and Compton out top. 6:40 and counting left in this ball game. Andy Hayes, Neil Connor with you. It's been a good one thus far. Here's McClung. Back out top. Great pass to Dean for three. Got it. Wide open. And a great assist from McClung. Fantastic shot by Dean.
Yeah, it really was. It's interesting. Gate City keeps working off the picks down into the corner. Every once in a while, I think you want to try to work that to the middle of the floor a little bit more. But the plan came together quite nicely right there for him.
Here's Jones underneath. No good. Couldn't get it to fall.
Good, tough move. Let's see here what they got. Trying to find him. There he is.
McClung fouled by Prelor.
Fairly clean game here, Andy. 4-3 for the team fouls. Radford and Gate City, respectively. Tough miss there.
Cormany loses control and another turnover. Quickly ahead to Irvin. And Irvin lays it in. Out of that timeout. A 5-0 run here for the Blue Devils.
You know, knowing how good of a team Radford is, it's tough to think what Graham did to Gate City.
Here's Edwards trying to back down on the block. Can't do it. Sally with the rebound. And a foul on Edwards. Swings of emotion and momentum in this one, back and forth.
Well, Radford, for the first time, kind of starting to show some emotion here that is not necessarily positive, getting a little frustrated.
Looks like maybe there's some blood.
Yeah, maybe got a
on
scratch.
Prelo's hand. He's got to come out.
Definitely some discussion here about what's going on. And that Radford staff not seeing it or something. And definitely the Radford faithful not liking the call. So anyway, sub in. Here we go. McClung bringing it up the floor for him.
There's McClung in the corner. Now Compton will bring it back out. And a near steal by Morton Robertson. Dean saves it. Quickly up to Mac McClung. He throws up the shot. Count it. And a foul.
Wow. Great shot. I'm not sure he was in the act of shooting, but the official thought he was, and it was a fantastic shot coming off of that foul. Showed some really nice touch right there. Good body control. Raff are going to take a break.
So a timeout will be called. Last time out, it looked like Radford was going to come all the way back and maybe tie this thing up.
Yeah.
Gate City comes right back with two buckets of their own. It's back to a 10-point deficit for Radford. Bradley Dean with a big three-point shot. And it looks like maybe somebody's been teed up. Technical foul called against Radford.
I hate to see that at this point in the game, you know. And I'm sure he was probably deserving, but, you know, all the times I've been involved in administering tournaments and that type of thing, you really try to encourage your officials not to get involved in that manner unless it's something just really egregious. And I'm sure it was. This crew's done a nice job tonight, but you just hate to see it for the kids. So that's a big momentum swing there. Looks like McClung will shoot three times, and they'll get the ball back as well. The Radford folks got a little upset there. McClung misses the first. Got a little upset there with the call on the scrape or whatever on Prelo.
McClung will have another.
Two more, I believe.
Yep.
Shoot the common first or the technical first. I don't know. I don't guess it matters. He's going to shoot three, and they're going to get the basketball.
Official asking Coach Cormier to sit down. And McClung misses the second one.
Wow. Sometimes it's tough to shoot them when you stand there by yourself.
And that one in.
Makes
it one out of three.
Yep.
Makes it an 11-point lead for Gate City.
Well, a crucial, crucial possession right here for Gate City.
Pick and roll with Irvin. He's got it back out top.
Well, Gate City rightly is out just fine to burn clock. Radford's going to have to pressure the ball to get the count started.
Compton in the corner. Back to McClung. He'll try. Throws up the jumper in the lane. Got it. 2:30 seconds and then knock home with Jay.
Yep.
Morton Robertson for three. Big shot there by Quentin.
Yeah,
they needed that one.
Quentin not ready to be done.
And if I'm Radford, you know, I'm going to take my chances with the ball in his hands. He's absolutely been the man for him, and get him to rock and hope for good things.
That's the bucket that was on the foul, and then this one right after. Starting to heat it up a little bit. Mac McClung and this young man, Quentin Morton Robertson, doing his best to keep his team in it. A 10-point deficit, 54 left here in the ballgame. Well, Radford running out of time.
Well, they are, but I'll tell you, both these teams score really quickly. You know, when things start coming together for them, doesn't take them long to add the points on the board. And Radford's done a great job of keeping McClung pretty neutralized tonight. Starting to find his legs and his shot here towards the end, but two guys on him have definitely made his night tough.
Storyline of the game really is the fact that as they double team McClung, the other guys in the lineup have really played great. I mean, they've knocked down big shots.
They have.
And they're showing they're a full team. They're a complete team. Here's McClung again. Air balls that one. Rebound Dean. And that's what I'm talking about. I mean, all the attention on number zero.
Right.
And there's Dean coming up with another big play right there. That's been the storyline tonight. They've been able to find those baskets and those rebounds.
Right. And when we were talking earlier, you know, you're talking about him being unselfish. And, you know, it's good to be unselfish if you're the star, but you got to have people that can do something with it or it just doesn't work out. The Gate said he definitely has those kids.
10-point lead for the Blue Devils. Trying to punch their ticket to state semifinals.
Nobody's been terribly impressive from the line.
No. Good point. 52-41. Here's Morton Robertson for three again. Oh, my goodness. What a shot. Drains it with a man in his face.
He's got a nice stroke, man. He is just such a pure basketball player. It's fun to watch. And again, like I said, if I'm going to go down, if I'm Coach Cormany, I want it in number two's hands. Let him do his thing. And if he makes it happen, great. And if he doesn't, you know, you put your best at him.
And they give him a three-pointer. Should have been a three-pointer. They're going into the scorekeeper right now. That should be a three-point shot. He's clearly behind the line. So 52-44. Here in the arena, they've got 52-43 on the scoreboard. The Radford coaches are asking about whether or not that was a three.
They haven't given it to him so far, but he obviously was way back there. I'd hate to see this not turn out to be a three, because, and I guess there is no review in high school basketball. Is that correct, Andy?
They're saying it was a three-point shot. Good job by the official.
There we go. Glad they got that
fix,
right.
That's right.
Yeah, glad they
clearly,
got it right.
Clearly a three-point shot. He's 5 feet behind the line. Here's McClung, gliding in, hangs in the air, and gets fouled.
I bet he'd like to have that one back, man. Got all the way to the rack there, and really, he did get fouled, but it was before he went up with it, kind of. But he wishes if he had another crack at that, that would be 2 points and one. So this has been a dicey proposition tonight.
Let's see if Mr. McClung can knock down a couple free throws. That'll be big if he can. And he does on the first one.
If you're going to miss any, miss them early and start making them down the stretch. See how he does on the second one.
Second one good.
Not a doubt.
Thank you. Here's Morton Robinson.
Fouled on the dribble. And then just chucks it in. So a 10-point lead here for Gate City. 3 minutes to go. Radford's got to turn it up right here.
Morton Robertson's been the guy. He's going to take another 3-point shot. A little bit off on that one. Almost fell again. Quickly ahead to Compton. And a smart decision right there by Compton.
Yep.
Pulled it back. Said, let's get some time off the clock.
Heads up. Very heads up play.
Here's McClung. Lays it in. Got around the defender. And put it off the glass and in.
He's starting to add to his stat line pretty well here in the second half.
Oh, wow. Morton Robertson in the lane with the runner. Got it.
Well, you might have caught a couple extra steps there, but no harm, no foul.
Here's Irvin. Well, he'll be fouled by Jones.
Well, Jones made the right play. I mean, you got to make sure he doesn't get it up on the rim at this point. Again, make him shoot the two 15-footers instead of making that layup, and don't give him a chance for an and one.
Free throw, no good. 2-11. He'll probably put it away here.
Got the second one. Yeah, I agree, Andy. Two of those might make things a little different. Don't want to foul here if you Gate City. Want to make sure if they score, the clock's running.
Another off-balance 3-point shot, no good. Rebound from Edwards, though. He gets it back. Pops one up in the air, no good. Jones has got it. Jones will try to dunk it. Goes in.
That was a nice follow. Nice rebound. Nice follow.
And a turnover, the pressure. They throw it out of bounds back to Radford, 57-48.
It should be under the bucket. Yep.
Bobcats, maybe with a little hope here. 3-point shot would be big right now, wouldn't it? Put it back to a 2-possession game.
You got to do something pretty quick. You can't hold on to it too long.
Jones fires up a shot, no good. Irvin's got the rebound. Double team, fouled by Prather.
Well, of course, we don't have any stats here, Andy, but it feels to me like Gate City's probably won the boards in this half. Which when you're not shooting real well, as Radford hasn't shot terribly well in this half, a lot of times that happens. Everybody's out of position when the ball goes up. But I thought Gate City's done a nice job of staying on the glass.
Free throw good from Irvin. Starting to see some fans file out of here. They think this one might be in hand. And that one drops as well. Back to 11. There's Morton Robertson. No good. All knocked out of bounds off of Radford. And the Blue Devils are a minute and 26 seconds away from the end of the next round of the VHSL Class 2 playoff.
Well, you hate to see Radford's season potentially come to an end right here after the 27-0 run. And I think probably, we've talked about it in the football games we've called. Maybe one of the best things that happened to Gate City was getting beaten, by Graham. It definitely changed your paradigm. Makes you understand where you're weak, what people can do to you to neutralize you. So in that regard, it's tough to keep that goose egg on the right-hand side, even if you have a fantastic basketball team, because some nights it just doesn't work out.
So 59-48 in front of a packed house here. It's been a team performance tonight from Gate City that's led to this 11-point lead.
Yeah, it has been. Looks like a little mutual respect there between Morton Robertson and Mr. McClung. Chet.
Foul by Cormany will put Irvin on the line. And the Gate City faithful have come to their feet.
Yeah, this one is probably pretty much out of hand at this point, unfortunately, for the Bobcats.
Free throw good.
And again, Gate City wants to concentrate on not fouling, staying on the glass.
Second one as well, 61-48. There'll be a new champ in Class 2, it appears. As the defending champ is getting set to go home here for the first time this season. Don't want to get ahead of ourselves, but with a minute 12 left, looks like it's going to be a Gate City win.
Yeah, Radford not getting quality shots now, and, you know, you get that desperation, and they're, again, another example of that. It's tough to – oh, wow.
Hard foul by Jones. We'll send Sally to the line for a couple.
Frustration really starting to show for the Bobcats here, and you hate to see that. And I guess if you don't ever lose, it's tough to know how.
Jones, it appears, has fouled out. What a great season for Miles.
Yeah, well, you can't take the fouls with you. That one there was borderline intentional, unfortunately.
So Jones will head to the bench.
Maybe they did call an intentional. I don't know. Oh, here we go. Now Radford's getting down in there.
First free throw is good.
Don't really understand why McClung's back there, honestly. Not really much use to be down there, and that could have very well been a foul. You don't want to stop the clock.
Turnover, McClung forced it.
He
kind of hung around.
And I guess that's why I'm not coaching a near state championship basketball team.
Put a little pressure on the ball, and he was fortunate enough to get a hand on it and went off of his opponent right out of bounds.
Yeah, it's just it's tough when that clock's running and they're down by that much. I'm surprised Radford's not fouling here. I don't – this whole end of this thing.
There's Irvin leaning in. He gets the bucket off the glass. Corner shot from Cormody. No good. Tipped away by Dean. Compton straight ahead to Irvin. Irvin wants to flush it. He missed it, but a foul called.
Wow. That would have been something else. Big old exclamation point if he could have pulled that down. And that's probably going to do it there, Andy, for sure.
66-48. And Gate City's going to move on to the next round.
Play the winner of the Graham-Martinsville game.
Should be a good one. Here's Morton Robertson with a nice runner in the lane. Can't get it to fall. Prelo gets it back. He'll chuck a three up, and that one swatted by Irvin.
He's had a big night.
Big time. Just a junior, too. 6'4".
Big kid. A lot of big kids out there on the floor.
Here's Edwards. Throws it up. No good. Compton's got the rebound. And the storybook season continues for Gate City. The Blue Devils moving on to the state semifinals.
Yep. Congratulations to them. It was a great ball game. I don't think the score really represents what we saw tonight. Radford had a tough time putting it in the bucket in the second half.
Congratulations to Coach Vermillion. And the Blue Devils on a great win, 67-48, the final score here tonight.
Yep, and congratulations to the Bobcats. They got absolutely nothing to be ashamed of. We knew when we started this thing somebody was going to go away not winning, you know, so they absolutely have nothing to be ashamed of. See everybody go through and show some good sportsmanship there. That's what you want to see. And at the end of the day, it is just a game. Disappointing, but it's just a game.
Always got to remember that. So congrats again to the Gate City Blue Devils. They'll play next week, Monday or Tuesday, I believe it is. We'll find out for sure over the weekend. They'll host. That'll be a great atmosphere
it's
as well.
Tuesday night.
Tuesday?
I believe so, yes.
Well, there's some questions. It's about some games and so forth, but we'll know for sure. It'll be up on the website. So make sure you check it out. We'll show you some second half highlights. A lot of momentum back and forth.
It was.
Neil, there were a lot of momentum changes throughout the game where we didn't really know how it was going to go. At one point, it looked like Gate City would run away with it. Radford would come storming back, led by their talented point guard, Morton Robertson. But every time they got close, Coach Vermillion would call a timeout.
Yep.
They'd come out of the timeout and go on a little run, wouldn't they?
They did. And I thought, you know, Gate City, as I said, both of them slowed it down the second half. And when Morton Robertson was hot and Cormany was hot there at the beginning of the second half, things were going really well for Radford, but they kind of got cold, and then seemed to me Gate City chipped away a little bit more and slid into the open spots, maybe did a little better job on the boards down the stretch.
Right here at the seven-minute mark, that was the window for Radford. If they had been able to come out of the timeout down three and hold,
right,
you know, they would have been in good shape to maybe make this thing a nail-biter down the stretch, but they allowed Mac McClung and the Blue Devils to come back and really get a nice run together toward the end of the ball game, put it back up to eight, then a big shot in the lane and a foul, went to 11, and really after that, Mac McClung started to take over, and
yep,
Radford was unable really to put a continuous effort towards a rally.
Well, and after that last three we saw from Morton Robertson, Radford got a little bit more, you know, what appeared to me to be desperate. And so some of the shots down the stretch just were ill-advised and rushed. And it's just tough to make those things from that far out when you got a good look and you got your feet set. That was a walk. But it's definitely tough to make them if you're falling down.
Zach Irvin, he played a big part tonight as well. The passing all the way around tonight for Gate City was fantastic.
It was.
They fed the ball to the open guy. They tried to double-team Mac McClung, and that's the right approach. I would have done the same thing.
Shoot,
you coach
yeah.
basketball, I mean, you'd have done the same thing.
Yep.
You can't let him dominate the game, and so they forced other guys to step up, and they did.
And they
so
did.
Tip your
that's
cap.
Right.
That's what you got to say when
yeah.
you play a great team.
And that's right.
And that was the difference.
You have to live with it as a coach. You know, you have your game plan. You stick to it, and if the other guys do end up beating you, like you said, you tip your cap and just pat them on the back and, you know, because you know what the results are if you don't double-team them. So
our final score here tonight, Gate City 67, Radford 48. The Blue Devils move on to the Class 2 Boys State Semifinal coming up here early in the week. And with that, we'd like to thank our entire production crew here tonight. Helene Shane, Austin Sowers here with the production team up top with us. Christian Sowers, Dwayne Ashwell, and Jacob Spears on our camera crew here this evening. For Neil Connor, I'm Andy Hayes. We'll sign off with one final score, Gate City 67, Radford 48. Championship basketball is coming up right around the corner next week. Make sure you tune in right here to the NFHS Network. So long, folks.